Okay, the background information. The Student Government Association has 13 members. It also has president, vice president, secretary, parliamentarians, and that whole board. There is a requirement for the Student Government Association. It is to have a 2.0 to become a member, and the requirement to become an officer is higher. They meet every Tuesday, including this Tuesday, at 4 p.m., where you are more than welcome to come and sit down and hear what they are talking about. And if you like what you hear and you feel like you want to become involved and fight for your rights on campus, you can sign up and see if you meet the requirements to join that club. Okay, so we all have problems and issues on campus, such as tuition, scholarships, parking, or like maybe a bus with ISIS building. Because some people do walk here, and it's very inconvenient to them because they have to spend 20 minutes walking over here when they probably have a class at NZI-15 and they have a class that starts at 7:30. So today we're going to talk about three examples and three reasons how Student Government Association did make a difference, whether it was on this campus or off this campus, and why you should join and why you should let your voice be heard, because there are people that want to hear your voice and you can cause change in this campus. So first we're going to talk about the survey that we went to a meeting and we got from the survey that they put on your campus, the top one on the homepage, and then the UTRGV student government and what they did for their student that semester, and the scholarship opportunities that are available on campus. And Samantha, you go ahead.
So like she said, the Student Government Association from here from UTSC, they did a survey for you to fill. I don't know if you guys filled it out, but we went to the meeting, we got the results from it, and only 100 students had done it, and it was like up for one day, but it was up in total for a week. Because it is like for you guys to put what are your issues in campus, so it's good for you guys to fill them out. Whenever in the meetings they choose the three top problems that students have and they take action to resolve them. So like on the past surveys, they put that, students put that it is very important to have a cafeteria in TSC, so they're working on that, so in the future we might have a cafeteria. And yeah, it's important for you guys to fill them out so they can know what issues you have on campus and so they can take action to resolve. And here's a picture of it. I don't know if it's kind of dirty, but it was question number two, how important is food services on campus? And it was extremely important, 44 students answered that it was extremely important. So we might get a cafeteria.
And keep in mind that when we do get a cafeteria, they will be handing out surveys on what you want to be served in that cafeteria. It may not happen next semester, maybe the semester after that, but the cafeteria will come if y'all keep getting your voice heard out there.
Giving them feedback, what you want. Rodrigo Ruiz, a sophomore at UTRGV, presented his concerns about transportation from the Rio Grande City to UTRGV to the Student Government Association. So he went to them, to the SGA from UTRGV. He presented that he wanted transportation from the Rio Grande City to Brownsville and to Edinburgh. So they heard him, and then the president from the SGA over there went to the president from UTRGV, and then she told them that she showed them all the emails that a lot of students want transportation. So she told them like go to the Rio Grande City and see how many students actually need transportation. So they went and they got his transportation. So now there's transportation from the Rio Grande City to Edinburgh and Brownsville. So now like that's something that the SGA did that for a student to help them out in transportation. So it's really important. And most of you guys in the survey we did said that the tuition piece was, 14 of you guys said that the biggest issue on campus was the tuition piece, which is 7%. And we walked around the campus and we saw that there's a lot
Okay, so now we went over the good stuff. I know some of you guys really have objections, like they can be time consuming, but in reality, they meet like 30 minutes to an hour every Tuesday, so I mean, you get more out of it than the time you actually spend in it. So. And also another one might be intimidation. A lot of you guys are shy. I'm shy too. I'm shy being up here, so. I mean, but you gotta remember that as a group, we're all stronger, so the more you get your voices heard and get involved, the more you can do about it. Alternative solutions. A lot of you people might say, well, I could be a free rider. Free rider, what it means is that you still benefit from the outcome, but actually do nothing about it. So basically, you don't want to be labeled as that person. You want to be involved and be able to say, you know what, we did it because we all got involved, and this is the outcome. Another solution might be remain silent, which means, I mean, pretty straightforward, just stay quiet, be in the dark, and don't do anything about any issue. This is me.
Hashtag selfie.
I actually recently attended one of the TSC board meetings, which is really interesting, guys. Like, I never thought that there's a lot going on in campus, but if you get a chance and attend a meeting, I mean, there's a lot of issues that are discussed throughout this meeting. Some of the board of trustee members, you have the president, the secretary, the vice president. When I attended the meeting, I noticed that before every meeting, they allow 3 minutes before the whole meeting starts to have anybody in the audience, it could be anybody, voice any concerns. So let's suppose you have a concern about a financial aid or something, they give you that you could voice your concern out. I mean, a lot of people don't know about it, but if just by attending and you're in the audience, you can go ahead and talk about some of the problems in school. This is a picture I took. A lot of the board trustees, you have the president, the vice president, the secretary, and so forth. You have some of the financial aid personnel there too. So, I mean, if you guys get to attend one, it's pretty interesting.
The call to action. So you guys should not stay quiet for like, if you have a problem, you might think like, oh, they're not gonna do anything about it, or like, they don't care, like I'm only one person. Like, a lot of students maybe have the same issues that don't wanna talk about it. But yes, you guys should not stay quiet and join the SDA so you can be heard.
And making a difference. I myself am going to the meeting today at 4 p.m. Y'all should come and join me and watch and see what it's all about. When we plant the WIM for the first time last Tuesday, my sister persuaded us, when I go interview her, and she's like, we'll come to the meeting. And I'm like, okay. So I went to the meeting, and me and Samantha ended up joining after that. And I am going to run for I'm president of the Student Government Association next semester. And I encourage you guys to go. And like, get your voice out there, because there's so much difference that we can make if we're in a whole. If one person marches, it doesn't make a difference. But if three